So I'm sitting with Dominic Loughran. Dominic, you work with the Niall Mellon Township. What's your actual title?
I'm the Director of Operations. So it started in 2002.
Yeah.
And since then, we've brought 5,500 volunteers to South Africa. And we've built 12,000 houses in that 7-year period.
My God.
Currently, we employ about 1,700 people in South Africa, and we're building approximately 500 houses every month. And that really all started by the good, very generous contributions by our own volunteers.
My God. How many houses a month, said it to me again?
500 houses a month.
500 houses a month.
We're currently building, we have 23 different townships in South Africa.
Yeah.
10 are in Gauteng, which is the Johannesburg region, and 13 are in the Western Cape, which is in and around Cape Town. I met Niall at a building show where I had done a show garden. And I heard about the trust and said, what would you think if I brought out, I think initially I said 7 gardeners. We ended up taking 54.
My God.
And we took 107 last year. It is going to change your life. It will put all things into perspective for you. And I remember a great conversation with Archbishop Tutu earlier this year, where he said, no matter what you're doing here, you're still way up here.
Mm-hmm.
As if Africans are still way down there. It's that 1 week in your life that's going to make a huge difference.
Mm.
Not just to you, but also to the beneficiaries, the people that you meet while you're there,
while
they're building houses for them, or constructing gardens, as you would have been involved in the last number of years. In relation to skills, it doesn't matter what you can do. There's a job for absolutely everybody. So whether you're a block layer, or a plasterer, carpenter, gardener, or you're just there to give out tea or sun cream or water to people, some administrative work. So there's a job for absolutely everybody. The one thing I can say is that the 1 week of your life, this will make all the difference.
In around about the time that I was there, I think it was just
in November last year, we built 253 houses in 1 week.
In 1 week?
In that scheme, there's 850 houses in Kailish and Site C.
And
I should note that that's an area where absolutely no other, be it an NGO or a building contractor, haven't been to build government houses.
Right.
We were the only successful NGO contractor to win there and build houses, and we hope to be in there for a long time to come yet. But we've done a community hall that would take 1,500 people in conjunction with the Archway Foundation. We built a 4,000 square metre garden, and then we built a number of vegetable gardens in 3 of the local schools all in 1 week, and we have maintained contact with the schools and the community in relation to the upkeep and maintenance of the gardens.
Mm.
And some of our volunteers, they actually help set the agenda every month, so that the local residents have something to work towards. So it's all about self-sustainability.
Yeah.
And we're eagerly pursuing that, and will in future years. And come November, again, looking at one of the schools there, we have a community hall, an agreement done for that. We hope to put in, again, another communal garden and a football pitch, because sporting facilities, again, are something that the local community want. So you can't have it just that you're a house, that you go and build houses. You have to have other integrations within the community, and
we've
found that this is both a good way for communal activity, but also for people to learn about self-sustainability.
Just very briefly, how many people this November are intending to go to travel to South Africa this year?
At this moment in time, we've just over 1,000 people registered to come.
It's not bad.
And it's also worth noting that this month alone, I was in Johannesburg last week, where we had 500 South African volunteers from South African breweries, and that was on Monday to Friday. On the Saturday, we had 250 students, South African students, on a build in Cape Town, and just yesterday we had 165 staff from First Rand Bank, including their CEO, who came and led blocks for the day.
Like that.
So it's not just, you know, I think we take it that the Irish started this process and they inspired others to join in. And we would hope now, this is going to be our first year, I think, where we'll have South African volunteers will outnumber Irish volunteers. But it's the inspiration that came directly from Ireland.
Okay.
And the little spark that has ignited this great movement for making a difference. And that's what it's all about.
Okay. Dominic probably doesn't know this, but I put up a photograph of me with on the web playing water polo with the bunny cap on with a little knot tied underneath it. And the very, very kind people of the blog world donated 350, 400 euro approximately just for that photograph alone.
The first major expense for our volunteers is getting physically out to South Africa, you know, and that probably takes up 1400 to 1500 euro. The
yeah.
balance then goes directly towards the building costs for that particular blitz and the logistics of it. And then the balance of that will go towards our ongoing house building programme in South Africa. But we endeavour at every corner, every stage, that we reduce our costs as much as possible so that everybody who contributes, volunteer and all the supporters, and let's face it, the supporters really are give a huge amount to the overall programme, that their money is spent as wisely as it possibly can be.
Mm. On September the 12th, we're doing a day in the National Garden Exhibition Centre in Kilquade.
On the day, we hope to look at, you know, self-sustainability. That's a big thing with our trust and the work we do in South Africa. And we'd like to approach that there, you know. So we put in, we have people who are going to speak about vegetables and self-sustainability. And there'll also be lots of other things. There's lovely coffee and cakes in the cake shop.
Lovely
lots
cakes.
For children to do.
Lovely cakes.
And but it's a lovely, it's a very homely venue to go to. But it has lots of interest for everyone. So whether you're just going popping along to buy a plant, to give us your support, to listen to some of the great experts that will be there on the day, or just to visit a little oasis. As I say, it's just a pop outside of Dublin. There's something there for everyone. So it doesn't matter what plot you have. Maybe you don't have a plot at all, you know, maybe you're just interested in coming along for the day. The thing is, it's a great place to visit, to go along to. You meet lots of people of great interest. You'll hear from experts. So whether you're an amateur, aspiring to be an amateur, or a professional gardener, or just want a little bit of break for the day, I would say come along and you'll have a wonderful day and a wonderful experience.
Excellent stuff. Listen, Dominic, thanks very much. Really appreciate that.
Thank you, Peter.
Thank you, Neil.